वेलकम बैक टू द टेक सिविल लर्निंग माई डियर फ्रेंड्स. आई प्रोमिस्ड यू जस्ट गिव मी योर 20 to 30 minutes टाइम. यू विल श्योरली गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट व्हिच इज मेंशन इन द थंबनेल. सो प्लीज वॉच द वीडियो टिल लास्ट सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट वेरी क्लियरली. सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग आवर टाइम लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट वेरी क्लियरली और लेट्स स्टार्ट द टूडे लेक्चर. सो टूडे वील डिस्कस अबाउट द थर्मल स्ट्रेस. वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड अ लॉट्स ऑफ टॉपिक्स. So if you have not gone through that one, please go and watch the video so that means it will be very helpful for you to understand the concept. So especially today we'll discuss about the thermal stress, right? So let's understand the thermal stress, right? Please focus. It is a such type of stress, right? Means it is such type of stress when it is induced in the body, or it is a such type of stress which induced in a body due to or because of change in temperature, right? Means suppose this one is a body, then the thermal stress will be induced in this body because of change in temperatures. Remember, because of change in temperatures, the thermal stress always takes place, right? But there will be one conditions, right? When the body does not, right? Or when the body is not allowed to expand and contract freely, at that point, the thermal stress will be set up in the body. Right. If the body is allowed to expand or contract freely, then no stress will be set up in the body. Remember these two points. Right. Means thermal stress simply does not induced in the body which body is means what you call free to expand and contract. Right. Means when a body is rigidly fixed. Right. From the both the end. At that point. Right. Means let's understand. Suppose this one is a body. Right. When this body is fixed from both the supports, then it's very difficult to expand and contract, right? These types of body. At that point, when this body is subjected to heat or when this body is subjected to contract, at that point of time, a stress will be induced in this body. And hope you know means a stress. At that point, a stress will be induced in this body. So hope you understand what do you mean by thermal stress. Here let's understand means what you call thermal stress phenomena means more deeply. Suppose my dear friends, I have assumed a rectangular body or any suppose imagine a rod or any body, right? Suppose the means original length of this body is L as it is represented, right? L, right? T is means what you call rise in temperature, means change in temperature, right? Means the temperatures of this body means initially was, right, means 30 degrees Celsius. Then after means heating this body, after means a heat is subjected to means this body, then it goes to 90 degrees Celsius. Then there will be some change in temperature, that is final change means final temperature minus initial temperatures, that will give the rise in temperatures, or it may be the fall in temperatures, where Young's modulus, every material has their own value of Young's modulus, right? Similarly, alpha represent coefficient of means expansions. Means most of the students really don't know what do you mean by coefficient of expansions. So my dear friends, means if you need to understand coefficient of, means what you call expansions, just means it gives some means or it describes how the shape and size and its density of the body changes due to change in temperature, right? That is means nothing but the means we can say that coefficient of expansions. At the same time, as this body is not rigidly fixed, right, it is free to expand, right, or contract. So of course there will be some change in length takes place, that will be representation as del L, right? Because this body is not means what you call rigidly fixed here. So what happen if the rod is not rigidly fixed or means then of course extension will be given as, that is alpha T into L, where alpha is the coefficient of expansion, T is the change in temperature, and L is the original length of the object. So when the body is not rigidly fixed from the both the end, then of course there will be change in its means what you call shape and size takes place, right? Similarly, its expansions, either it contraction takes place, that is given by alpha T into L. So let's understand the thermal stress phenomena, right? For that once, what I did, I have draw three figures, right, which is fixed at one end, right? suppose the rod of having AB means its original length, and when the AB is subjected to heat, then of course there will be expansion takes place, right? It is means easy concept, we can understand clearly. When any body is subjected to, or when the any body is considers of having, it means heat, or when any body means when the heat is given to the any body, then of course there will be change in temperatures takes place. So this one's B to B dash, the change in or increase in temperature, that is represented at del L. Then what I did, I have just given a compressive means a load from the other end, right? So that due to the compressive load, the body comes to the original position, right? Means I have given a fixed support. So as it is means from the here figure, it is clear that AB represent the original length, right? And B dash B represent an increase in length due to rise, temperature rise, right? So from here you can understand the concept means very clearly. I am continuously providing means lecture with the proper handwritten notes so that you can understand the concept very clearly. So what happens means due to the external load applied to B means initially the length of the means what you call, as you can see in the figure, that means L plus del L, right? Means total means length of the means A to AB dice. So what happens due to the compressive load applied at the end, so it's changed from means del means L plus alpha TL, that is it can be also represented as del L to L, right? Means original shapes because of compressive load. So of course due to the compressive load there must be induced compressive strains, because a strain is induced in a body due to the load or the stress set up in the body. Remember that point. So compressive strain is nothing but the decrease in length to the original length. So the decrease in length is nothing but the change in length. What? Change in length. So change in length we have already calculated, that is alpha TL by original length is L plus DLL, right? So L plus DLL can be also written as L due to the compressive load. So when LL will be cancelled, that will be alpha into T. So alpha into T is the compressive strain induced in the body. So what will be the thermal stress? Of course before that we will calculate a stress induced in the body. So my dear friends, as you know, Young's modulus is equal to a stress by a strain. From here a stress is equal to a strain into Young's modulus. So a strain value we already calculated here, right? A strain value we have already calculated here, that is compressive strains, that is alpha into T, and E is the Young's modulus. So a stress induced in the above figure will be given by alpha into T into E. So similarly we will calculate what you call, and here you can calculate load, that is stress into area. So what I did means similarly we will assume that the both the end of the body is fixed, right? Means we are here assuming that the both the end of AB is rigidly fixed, right? At that time or at that point when the load is applied to the means rod, see the above figure I am drawing same. Right, suppose this one is A, right, and this one is B. Right, here what I did, I have just fixed these ones, rigidly fixed this one, right? And at the same time, I have also fixed this side. So here the stress will be induced, that stress is known as thermal stress. So before that means thermal strain will be induced, that is extension prevented, right? Means due to of having its support, right, means extensions or expansion does not take place, that will be original length. And we know that the extension preventing the change in length, that is del L to L, and we have already calculated means del L from the above figure, as you can see here. Yes, means from the above we have did, right, means in the means first steps, that one's by L. So LL will be cancelled, that is means alpha into T. So alpha into T will be the thermal strain. Similarly we will calculate the thermal stress, so means strain into Young's modulus. So alpha into T into E is the thermal stress induced in a body when a body is subjected to heat and a body is rigidly fixed from both the end. Now will means the thermal stress formula is alpha into T into A. So remember this formula, it will be very useful for the calculations point of view, and if you really understand this concept, it will be very easy for you to solve the numericals. Now let's understand the concept, the stress and strain when the support yields, right? At that point what happened, right? Means if the support yield means suppose imagine by the means amount of right means del right. Suppose we have taken means del amount of means stress means sorry means del amount of means support yield takes place. Then at that point what happened? Actual expansion. We need to calculate actual expansions, right? So extensions due to rise in temperatures minus del. Right, because this one is the means what you call extra amount of yield takes place because of means or the because of support yield. So that will be alpha T into L minus right del. So actual strain will be means what you call actual expansion by original length. So actual expansion we have already calculated, that is alpha into T into L minus del by L. Similarly, actual strain will be right stress means that one strain by strain into E, Young's modulus. So strain we have already calculated alpha into T into L minus del by L into E. So this one is the formula used to calculate the actual strains when the support yielding takes place. So remember these ones very clearly. So my dear friends, we have already discussed about the thermal stress. Now let's talk about the thermal stress in a composite bar, right? Right, we have already discussed about what do you mean by composite bar, how to solve a numerical based on composite bar. So no need to discuss about again and again all these things. So hope you know about the composite bar. It is of having the means combinations of two bars or having more than that, right? So here as you can see means this one is the bar, right, where one end is fixed and this one is brass, at the same time this one is steel. So from these means pictures or from this figure phenomena, you can understand that when the heat is subjected to these means two materials, then what happens? Because of heat, the brass expand or the means the expansion of the brass means easily takes place, right? Means here the expansion is more than that of steels, right? Means here the brass expansion is more and the steel expansion is more. At the same time, and the figure means C shows that suppose this one is represent figure A, right? This one figure B, this one figure C. But in the figure C, you can see that means both compensate each other, right? Means this length both compensate each other and both behave as a means a whole unit, right? Means both behave as a equal unit, right? So here means this one is a normal figure where heat is applied to the body. When the heat is given to the body, brass expansion takes place, right, in the compare of steels, and in the figure two, both behave like a means single unit. So what happens, my dear friends, understand this concept very essentials, right? When the heat is means given to the brass, then means expansion coefficient of this one is more, so its expansion takes place more. So here what happens means steel try to compensate it, right? Means it means brass means want to go up, right? At the same time steel try to pull it down, right? Means please come down, so like that it's behaving. So means due to of this brass and steel coefficient, both behave like a equal means both behave like a unit as a whole unit. So let's understand this concept very clearly. So as you can see that the above figure is a composite bar of having two member, that is brass and steels, and let the composite be heated, right? As I have told you, if the member is free to expand, then no stress will be induced in the place. Of course if the member is free to expand, then of course there will be no thermal stress takes place, as I have told you before that only. So here, but the two members are rigidly fixed, as I have told you, if the brass and steels, this one is rigidly fixed, hence the composite bar as a whole expand by the same amount. Yes, I have told you, if the both brass and this one is rigidly fixed, then both the means bar will behave, or both the bar expansions takes place, means same amount of expansion takes place, right? Means both of having the same amount of expansions. So as the coefficient of linear expansion of brass is more, yes, means what you call the alpha value of brass is more, so it will expand more than steels, right? Means remember always that if the coefficient of expansion of any material is more, then that materials will expand more, right? Try to understand my concept. So what happens, right, brass is having more alpha value, then it will expand more. So as you can see, both the members are not free to expand. Of course these both the metal it is fixed, rigidly fixed, then expansion of the composite bar is whole will be less than that of brass but more than that of steel, Right, means it is act as a means what you call means as a whole unit. So here you can see that the stress in the brass will be compressive, right? At the same time, the stress will be tensile, right? So this is why, because suppose this one is brass, right, and this one is steel, right? When the heat is given to that ones, then it will means what the steel, this one is steel. Steel try to pull it down, right? Because the coefficient of the steel is less than that of brass, right? This one is brass. So what happens? This steel try to pull it down, right? Means it try to pull it down, right? So here what happened in the brass means compressive stress will be induced. At the same time, what did this one's brass? Brass try to means pull it up, right? Means brass try to pull it up, right? So here in the steel, a tensile stress will be developed, right? Are you getting my point, my dear friends? So what happens? This brass try to pull it up, at the same time the steel try to pull it down. So both as a composite unit, both means in the both expansions takes place, that will be in the equal amount. So hope you understand this phenomena, right? This one's busy, very easy concept and very practical to the real life. So let's understand from the above figures, right? A means let's understand that is AB is the area of brass bar, right? Means sigma B the stress induced in bar, EB the strain in the means brass, means alpha B the coefficient of means brass, right? EB the Young's modulus of brass, and similarly AS sigma S ES is the means corresponding value of steel, right? Where means del is the actual expansion of the composite bar, and we have already deal about the actual expansion of the actual expansion takes place when the both ends are fixed. So my dear friends, as I have told you that as a composite bar, both the means brass and steel will act as a means what you call whole unit, right? Means equal amount of expansion takes place, right? So the compression in the bar will be equal to the tension in the steel, of course we have means no. So means compression load will be means given, so the load on the stress will be equal to load on the means steel. So the load can be given in the stress into it, that is sigma B into AS into means sigma S into AS. So my dear friends, please remember this procedures for means what you call solving the numericals, right? We have to adopt the similar procedures for solving the numericals, right? So means there is a no means much difference, right? So understanding this concept is very numerical. So means we know the compressive means compression in the bar is equal to tension in the bar. So the load on the bar is equal to load on the steel. So here means this one is assumed as equation 1. So my dear friends, this one is equation 1. So what happened? Actual expansion is steel is equal to actual expansion of brass. Of course, because both the bar is acting as a composite bar, and means the equal amount of expansion takes place. So the actual expansion we know, that is free expansion plus expansion due to tensile stress in the steel. At the same time, free expansion plus, that means in that ones what compression in steel, in brass, sorry, in brass compression is compressive means what you call stress takes place. So here the free expansion minus contraction due to compressive stress. So here free expansion we know alpha S into T into L. We know this formula from the thermal stress only. At the same time, plus, right, expansion due to tensile stress. We know the tensile stress, right? So due to tensile stress, tensile strain will be takes place. That is tensile strain will be given as sigma S into ES into L, right? That is original length. Similarly, minus sigma B into EB into means L. So LL will be cancelled, right? This L and this L will be cancel, so remaining will be alpha S into T plus sigma S by ES equal to sigma B into T minus sigma B by EB. So this is the second formula for calculating the actual, and from here you can calculate anything. So this is the concept related to the thermal means stress and the thermal stress in the composite bar. So hope you understand very clearly. So let's solve the some numerical so that all your doubt can be cleared, right? So there will be no chances of arising a doubt at all. So let's understand this concept. A steel of 3 cm diameter, right? Means there is one steel of having 3 cm diameter and 5 m long is connected to 2 grips, right? And the rod is maintained at a temperature 95 degrees and determine the means stress and pull exerted when the temperature falls to 90 degrees, right? Suppose imagine this one is a steel of having how much 3 cm dia, and it is means connected to the grape, right? Suppose this one is connected to grape, right? Means both end is fixed, right? This one is also fixed. So it means initial means its temperature is 95 degree, then it is means its temperature decreases to 30 degree. So it means and we have to find the end, do not means yield, and the means supports yield by 0.12 centimeter, that is del. So let's calculate where the Young's modulus of the material is given and the means coefficient expansion is given. So here means before solving the numerical, we have to write the given data so that it's very easy for you to analyze the numericals. So here diameter of the rod is given in 3 centimeters. I have converted into mm, so 3 into 10, so 30 mm. So from here I have calculated area of the rod. So pi by 4 into 30 squared, so area will be this much. Where the length of the rod is given, that is 5 meters, it will be 5000 mm, right, because meter into mm into 1000. So initial temperature T1 is given, so right, final temperature is given, so the fallen temperature T1 minus T2, that is 65 degrees Celsius, right. So the modulus of elasticity is given, right, 2 into 10 to the power 5 mega newton per meter square. So I have converted mega newton into newton per meter square, so into 10 to the power 6, as we know all about these one things. That coefficient of linear expansion is given. Here we need to calculate, right, means when the end do not yield, right, means normal conditions. So at that point a stress will be given as alpha into T into E, right, because we need to calculate a stress and the load. So a stress alpha into T into E, alpha value we have given, T value we have, E value we have. So that will be means 156 into 10 to the power 6 newton per meter squares. So this will be the answers of the stress. So if you want to convert these ones into mm squares, then 156 newton per mm squares. This is how, because right, 156 right by into 10 to the power 6, if you convert meter square into mm squares and it is in per, right, so that is a per divided by into means 1000 into 1000, right, 1000 into 1000, so means 10 to the power 6, then both will be cancelled, remaining 156. So I have already discussed about all these things in the lecture first only, means how to convert, right, unit conversion. So please go and watch that video, so that means there is no chances of arising any doubt at all, because I have explained really well in the first means lectures. So here the pull on the rod or the load can be stress into area. Stress we have already calculated 156. So 156 into area, here this much means load is means applied on the rod, right. Now we need to calculate when the yield means support yielding by 0.12 centimeter, right, means that is 0.12 into 10, that is 1.2. so a stress formula is given, that is alpha into T into minus del by L into E. So just substitute the value and calculate all the value, because it's come in newton per mm square, so pull in rod will be the same. So this is the concept, or this is the numericals. So every numericals is based on these steps only, so there is a means no need to worry about all these things. If you really have a concept on any topics, then you can solve the numericals means very clearly. Let's solve one numericals based on the composite bar, right. Here as you can see, a steel tube 30 centimeters external diameter, right, there is a steel tube external means, and the 20 centimeter internal diameter encloses with a copper rod, right, means a steel rod of have external 30 centimeter diameter. Means in any problem, try to understand the concept, then you can analyze it, then try to solve it. There will be a steel tube, right, there is a steel tube of 30 centimeter diameter and its internal diameter is 20 centimeter, and it is encloses, right, means it is covered with the copper rod of 15 means centimeter diameters, right, means suppose this one is a steel, right, means this one external diameter is means what you call 30, internal to internal diameter is how much, 20, then there is encloses with copper, right, how much diameter, 15 diameters, to which it is rigidly joined at the each kernels, it is rigidly joined. If the temperature is 0 means 10 degrees Celsius to right, there is a no longitudinal stress. So calculate the stress in the rod and tube when the temperature rises to 20 means 200 degrees Celsius, right. So E for a steel is given and the copper, right, this one is E for a steel and this one is for copper, right. The value of coefficient of linear is given, that is this ones and this ones. So here we need to calculate the means stress induced in that one. So it's very means stress induced in means what you call steel and stress induced in copper. So as I have told you, means the first steps of any numerical is to write the given data. So diameter of copper is given, that is represent DC. So area of means a means what you call copper rod, that is AC, will be pi by 4 into 15, so this much. सिमिलर एरिया ऑफ स्टील ट्यूब एज स्टील ट्यूब ऑफ हैविंग मीन्स 20-30 सेंटीमीटर डाया एंड 3 सेंटीमीटर डाया एंड 2 सेंटीमीटर डाया सो विल कन्वर्ट इन टू मीन्स फॉर द होलो सिलेंडर वी कैन कैलकुलेट पाई बाई 4 कैपिटल डी स्क्वायर माइनस स्मॉल डी स्क्वायर सो 30 स्क्वायर माइनस 20 स्क्वायर इट विल कम दिस वंस सो द चेंज इन टेम्परेचर फाइनल टेम्परेचर माइनस इनिशियल टेम्परेचर दैट इज 190 डिग्री सेल्सियस सो यंग्स मॉडुलस वैल्यू ऑफ स्टील इज गिवन यंग्स मॉडुलस वैल्यू ऑफ कॉपर इज गिवन अल्फा वैल्यू ऑफ स्टील इज गिवन अल्फा वैल्यू ऑफ कॉपर इज गिवन सो एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट एज यू कैन सी फ्रॉम हेयर द कॉपर इज हैविंग द मोर व्हाट अल्फा वैल्यू द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्सपेंशन इज कॉपर इज मोर सो द कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेस विल बी इंड्यूस्ड इन द कॉपर राइट एट द सेम टाइम्स इट इज हैविंग मीन्स लेस सो देर विल बी टेंजाइल स्ट्रेस हेयर द टेंजाइल स्ट्रेस विल बी इंड्यूस्ड इन स्टील एंड द कॉपर स्ट्रेस विल बी इंड्यूस्ड इन वेयर copper means compressive stress will be induced in copper right and I have explained this phenomena means above itself so here means just we need to follow the same procedure so the compressive load in copper is equal to tensile load in this ones so this ones from here either you can convert in the terms of means sigma s or in the sigma c so I have converted in the sigma c so sigma s by as by ac right So here the means sigma s is remain as it is and we have already calculated AS value and AC value so it is 2.2 times of sigma c so let's see actual means at the same procedure actual expansion of steel is equal to actual expansion of copper so here we are just following the means above concepts only so as I have told you means it's a very easy type of concept just you need to follow So here alpha s into t into l plus sigma s right this one is means what you call expansions means due to tensile stress right so the means tensile strain will be sigma s by s into l and this one's in the copper there will be means what you call means compressive strain takes place because of having more alpha value So here means because of compressive here the minus will be induced. So my dear friend, no need to worry. Just substitute all these value. Sigma s t means sigma s value is given, t value is given, right? Here s will be as it is, right? E value is given, sigma c value is given, t value is given. Instead of even that here it will be s. Sorry, my dear friend, it will be s 2.2s. Let's substitute all these value. Bring these ones s in the place of means in these ones make a like terms in one side. So and substitute all this in one side. So if you do LCM of these ones, ultimately the value of sigma. Hope you can solve these ones, right? It's very easy. As an engineer, you must know how to solve these ones. So sigma s is equal to 35.23 newton per mm square. So this one is the stress induced in steel. Similar stress induced in copper is 2.2 times of that is sigma s. So we'll substitute the value, and you will get the stress in steel as well as the stress in copper so this is all about the concept of thermal stress hope you have understand this ones if you really understand please don't forget to comment in the comment sections or if you have any doubt then please contact us thank you for watching our video thank you take care bye bye